Okay, in the last part that we discussed, we did the derivation of these equations. Remember that the integration of acceleration over time gives me velocity. So here I have my velocity as a function of time. Then the integration of velocity over time gives me position. So here I have my general position equation. So I have here position as a function of time. And then in this case, what I have is the acceleration as a function of distance. If I do that integration, I will get here the velocity. So if you see here, this is a different expression of velocity as a function of position, not of time. So these are the three equations that you need to remember for general terms and specifically for when you have, in this case, a special case of a constant acceleration, like in the case of gravity. Okay, so here the acceleration is a constant. So if you have constant acceleration, you would use these three expressions either as a function of velocity, distance, or a velocity as a function of distance. Okay, so we looked at this expression, and then here you have the expression for velocity. Again, the derivative of velocity gives me acceleration. Okay, and we looked at this expression, this problem. So the derivative of velocity, as I said, gives me acceleration. Then this is what we have. And to calculate the distance traveled, then if you have the velocity, the integration of velocity gives you distance. Okay, so this is what we have here. So we did the concept quizzes, important to understand those concept quizzes. And so what I want to do is to explain this problem. I thought it'd be good so you are able to work on the problem for the class. Okay, so we have a sandbag that is dropped from a balloon ascending vertically at a constant speed of 6 meters per second. The bag is released with the same upward velocity of 6 meters per second at time equals 0 seconds and hits the ground when time equals 8 seconds. So we have to find the speed of the bag as it hits the ground and the altitude of the balloon at this instant. So we're going to be using the one of the three or the three or two of the three expressions that we mentioned earlier. So this is what we have. So we have these expressions that are used for constant acceleration, which is the situation that we have now. If the acceleration was not constant and you had an equation, then if it asks for velocity, you integrate acceleration and then get velocity. If you want distance, then you integrate velocity to get distance. If you have the distance as a function of time, the derivative of distance gives me velocity, and the derivative of velocity gives me acceleration. So it's in that order, okay? So let's take a look at what the problem has. So you have a balloon, and someone drops a sandbag, okay? So at time equals 0, what we have is that the velocity 0 equals 6 meters per second, because it tells you that a sandbag is dropped from a balloon ascending vertically at a speed of 6 meters per second. And so this is usually we start with SO equals 0 at the moment where it's dropped, okay? And this is the ground, and then the time here equals 8 seconds. So that's all the information I have. And then I have to do two things. I need to calculate the velocity at time equals 8 seconds, okay? And then it's asking me what is the altitude of the balloon, not the ball, at t equals 8 seconds. So remember that at t equals 8 seconds, the balloon had to go up from this distance, and it kept going up. So you have the distance that the balloon went up plus the distance here that you have originally at this elevation. Okay? So let's calculate first. Well, I should have done. So the bag is released when time equals 0 seconds. So what you need to keep here very, very clear is what were your original variables. Okay? So let me go back to my expression. So the first question, let's say, what is the speed of the bag as it hits the ground? What is the speed of the bag as it hits the ground? So here I have the time, right? I have the acceleration of the velocity. So speed of the bag, so I'm doing kind of backwards. So let's take a look. I want to know what is that velocity? V0, I know that it was 6 meters per second going up, okay? And the time equals 8 seconds, right? So what I need to remember is, what am I going to use as positive? So here I had my S0, and I'm going to say that this velocity is positive. So when I substitute here, V equals V0 plus AC times T, then I have the velocity of the bag initially was negative minus 6 meters per second. The acceleration, because I'm using, oh, sorry. So the acceleration is going down, so it's also positive. So it's 9.81 meters per second, and then 1.8, I mean 8 seconds. So it's all depending on what you used as positive or negative. So what I did, I used this as positive, anything going down. So then the acceleration was positive because it goes down, but the velocity, the initial velocity, is negative because it's going up, and then I have here 8 seconds. Okay? So the velocity of the bag when it hits the ground is 72.5 meters per second, and because it's positive, it's going down in this case. Okay? You could have done it the opposite way, but it really doesn't matter. Okay? So now you have the velocity. The other question then is, what is the total distance of the balloon? So one thing I can do is, okay, let's find out what is this distance and then this other distance for the balloon. So if I use the bag that was thrown, I have the time here, I have the acceleration, and I have the original distance, which I said it was 0, and I have the initial velocity. So I can use this to find this distance that the bag fell. Okay? So let's go here. So what is important again is what you decided as your values. So whenever we had the balloon, right, and the bag falling, we said this is S0 equals 0. This is positive. This is the ground. So we want to find this distance. And here the velocity was negative 6 meters per second. And the time here, t is 0, but then the time here is 8 seconds. Okay? So you just use this equation, which is equation 2, and do the substitution. The distance here was 0, as I said. The velocity 0 of the bag was minus 6. The time is 8 seconds, this is the expression, acceleration, and then the time. So this distance here is 265.9 meters. Okay? So the question now is, at 8 seconds, how high did the balloon go up? Okay? So then I use the equation, and let me go back. So I can use this expression for the balloon. If it's constant acceleration, okay? So remember that if I have acceleration is constant, okay, the velocity multiplied by time gives me a distance. Okay? So here is this expression. So it's 48 meters. Okay? So in this case, what is important to remember is that all the expressions that we have are for constant velocity are these three expressions, okay? And those are the expressions that you will use. I hope that this helps clarify some of the problems. So we had to add these two distances here, 314 meters. This should help you complete all the problems for Thursday. Thank you.